What's good, YouTube? Today we're starting the video a little differently. Right now, me and Jay are actually sliding over to Effingham, which is about 40, 45 minutes away from us. We're going to see a barber that we both know. I know him because he hit me up because he knew I cut in the area. And Jay knows him through barber school. He's a cool dude, though. Older guy, a little older school, but, you know, he's cool. He's doing his thing over here in the area. I think he wants to open up a barber school, so shout out to him. But I hope y'all enjoy the video today. Hope y'all enjoy the cut. If you do, make sure you hit that like button, drop a comment, share with a friend. I appreciate you tapping into my video though, and let's get straight to it.
What's up with the barber lines?
Back home, big dog. See, looks looking right in here though, man.
Thanks. In my house.
It's smooth.
I like these chairs a lot.
Don't got no love for those who left me, nah, we ain't speaking. Your partner dead, you know who did it, so why he still breathing? Your bitch got caught texting a nigga, she say that ain't cheating. Nigga, you crazy if you fall for that, cause that
I
don't sleep.
I just wanna take the time, baby, tell you I'm there, and I'm gonna keep
feeling. This boy hella deep, man.
Y'all, remember this cut, remember this cut. This...
Hey, Hunter, say that's one of your cockiest
corners. Hunter Warren.
Right here, man.
He the next big thing. What's good, YouTube? I hope you guys enjoyed that intro. I didn't know my guy was gonna show love like that in the video, but I appreciate it. And shout out my guy Donovan. You know, it's all love since I locked in with bro. But right here, we're just combing everything out, and then to start the cutout, we're gonna go with the one guard closed and just make sure you're cutting with the grain. You always want to cut with the grain on waivers. And I chose a one guard for him because he has more dense hair. So you can do the one guard and it'll make the waves look better. And will also create a good foundation for the high taper we're going to be doing on the sides.
Tough enough. Go get that money, baby, we gon' run it up. My dog crossed me, now he missed me, yeah, he knew what it was. I stayed silent from the jump, yeah, I'm so tired of broken love.
So right here, just start the high taper. I like to go right off the bottom of the vertical bar to about the top of the ear. Well, not even really the top. Y'all see right there. That's where I like to put it. Sometimes I'll give it more of a burst effect, but his vertical box is kind of small, so... You don't want to stretch it too much because you want that vertical box to be shown still. So I like to put his about right there. It really all just depends on the client. But right here, we got the lever open, setting in about an inch guideline because we're fading into a one closed with the grain, which a one open against the grain will blend, you know, right into most of the time. You might have to touch it up a little bit, but overall, it's going to blend right in. So to take out that line, I like to break it down into three steps. I'll go with the lever closed at the bottom, and then halfway on the lever and halfway up that guideline, and then lever open, it'll all be blended out. You might have to detail a little bit, but most of the time, you know, it'll give a good blend. So right here, we got the one guard open. Like I said, it should blend right into that one guard closed with the grain we did on top. And really right here, you're just not even really setting a guideline since it blends right in. You're just kind of preparing for the half guard work that we'll do in the next step. So right here, I'm using that half guard. Really, on tapers, I like to use just the corner of the blade like you guys see here. Doing this, it really all just depends on how much space you have to fade. And with tapers being more of a, you know, condensed space, I like to use the corner just so I don't cut too much. Right here, we're just gonna go ahead and start on the back taper. I didn't cut it down earlier just because I wanted y'all to see it, but this is how you cut the back one guard closed, like on top, and just going with the grain, especially on the crown. The crown usually swirls, so you want to go with the swirl. Make sure you don't cut against it, or you know, it'll be a lot lighter than it's supposed to be. So right here, I'm gonna go ahead and clear out a foundation for the back taper. I'm just doing a one guard open, and it blends, you know, right into the one guard closed with the grain we already did in the last step. Really just clearing a foundation and making sure, you know, everything's ready for the taper. So right here to start the taper, I like to give the back taper kind of like a burst effect. So y'all see I put it like an arch shape. Doing this, I think it just gives a more unique look to my cuts. And it keeps the ear lineup dark, but also stretches the fade at the same time. I think it's a good, you know, a good trick. I would recommend it to anybody who cuts hair or wants to cut hair. But yeah, it gives a nice finished look for sure. So right here, I just got the lever all the way open, going up about an inch, and just making sure I follow that same burst pattern I set in the last step, and really just making sure the, you know, guideline is consistent with the last one. And then to take it out, I do the same steps on the back as I do the sides. I like to break it down into thirds, so I'll go with the lever closed at the very bottom of the line, and then I'll go halfway on the guideline and halfway on the lever. And then it usually blends, you know, all the way into the lever open. But with his, you see his hair growth pattern. It goes different ways. So you'll see me turn my clippers. I won't just cut right up the head. I'll turn them sometimes, like right here. Really, you just want to make sure you're cutting against the grain when you're fading and making sure, you know, all the hair is cut as evenly as possible. So right here, I'm going to go ahead and drop into one guard. Doing this, I have it closed, but I'm flicking into, you know, the foundation that we set open already. And I'm really just softening it and getting it ready for the half guard. So right here, I got that half guard on. I'll notice that I use the whole blade for the back. It really just depends because I have more space on the back. And you know, on the sides, there's not as much space on the taper. So that's when I'll use my corners. But for big areas like this, I'll use the whole blade most of the time. Right here, I'm doing just a little bit of detail work. I just wanted to throw that in for you guys. Because, I mean, even whenever you run through all your steps, there's always going to be spots that, you know, you missed or that just have to be cut differently. So, yeah, I'm just doing a little bit of detail work and just hitting, you know, those dark spots that I see. So, for all my lineups, I like to spray them with hairspray or any holding spray, really. I use Tresemme. I think it's the whole level is 4 or 5. I can't remember. I know it's the purple bottle though, or the purple can. But then just make sure you're brushing it all down and then give it time to dry. And then once you put the liners on it, it'll give it a nice white ash line look. And also just make sure, you know, you can give the most, I guess, natural lineup possible. Yo, GG! So for my lineups, I like to start at the bottom and then I will go to the top of the ear and then I'll meet them in the middle. And really for the ear lineups, I usually only use the last few teeth of my blade. I never like to use the whole blade just because there's not that much space to, you know, cut. So really just try using just the corners of your blade or even like half your blade at most. But yeah, that's how I do it. Right here, we're just lining up the other side, same steps. I already sprayed it with the hairspray. I didn't include that in the video, but same steps on this side. Y'all see the, you know, ash line look it puts on there though? I think it's a great, you know, finished look. It really just ensures that you're given the most natural lineup possible. Deep in the heart of me, yeah. So deep in my heart. Right here, we're just throwing some wave foam in, just making sure, you know, the hair is laying properly and just getting it ready for the lineup, really. Yes, I've got you. So same thing as the ear lineup. I'm just spraying, holding, spraying, and just really, you know, getting the hairline ready for the lineup. So I like to start my lineups in the middle, and then I'll work to one side and then line up the vertical bar, and then I will work to the other side. I found that this is the best way for me. I mean, everybody does it differently, but I like to line up one side, and then it kind of gives me a visual on how to do the other side. See here in the corner, it really shows it well once my arm moves, but using that hairspray, it gives that nice, you know, white glow to the outside of the hairline. And that's not razor work, that's not a pencil, that's just straight up hairline prep. Really doing a proper hairline prep will save you a lot of time and make your cut, you know, as natural and good looking as possible. Right here, we're just spraying in some enhancement. Like, you really can't spray much on his vertical bar just because, you know, it doesn't stretch too far down. So you really want to keep it light there. But on the front hairline, I am adding a little bit. Not too much, since because, I mean, really it was naturally crispy without it. So I didn't really need it, but I do like to add it because my clients like it. And I think, you know, I think it just finishes off the cut. And then once I do that, I like to tap it all in with the razor, because sometimes the card won't give a perfectly straight line, so you have to go back over it and just make sure, you know, all the colors in the right spot. So right here, I'm just doing some freehand work with my trimmers. I like to do this on all my wave cuts. I think, you know, it gives it a nice finished look and makes sure no hair is standing up. I used to be scared to do this, but it's really not bad. As long as you have the right technique, it's not bad at all. But yeah, YouTube, that pretty much wraps up today's cut. I hope y'all enjoyed it today. Maybe enjoyed that, you know, new style of intro and having the client conversation. If you did enjoy it though, make sure you hit that like button, drop a comment, share with a friend. I appreciate you if you sat to the end of the video though, and God bless.
I remember I went to Louis V with half. Watch them spread $10,000 on the glass. I never ever thought I'd see that in my life. Now I'm in the East cause them boys are getting right, man. I was on TV making 50 racks a year. After helping mama out, the shit would disappear. I am not a man, I can't do this on my own. So I started asking them if they would put me on. And they did put me on. Yeah, they did put me on. Now we in the
best barber. Best barber in the nation.
Line blowing up, working on the phones. Now we in the basement and we working on the phones. But I just couldn't do it, had to leave that shit alone, man.